of the cost of product, which is direct material plus direct labor plus the manufacturing overheads. So it will give us the product cost, but the overheads are not given product wise, but the total overheads are given, and these total overheads can be charged to the products by using some absorption basis. However, there is an additional information that there are four departments, two production departments and two service departments. So there is a need to allocate a portion and then absorb this 210,000 to the products. So in order to do that, let us first observe the allocation and apportionment of these 210,000 over P1, P2, P3. So the expenses are rent, utilities and canteen. And let us first do the rent, and the rent is apportioned on the basis of the area, and so therefore 20,000, 15,000, 10,000, 10,000 and 5,000 respectively to P1, P2 and accounts department R&D. In the same way, overheads are charged on the basis of the utility overheads are charged. Since no information is given about the actual consumption, once again we did it on the basis of the area, that is 40%, 30%, 20% and 10% respectively. Now comes the canteen expenses. The canteen expenses, the driver is considered to be the number of employees. So therefore, based on the number of employees, we apportion the overheads, that is canteen overheads, into P1, P2 accounts and R&D departments based on the employees ratio. So one has been done on the basis of the area, utilities has been done on the basis of the area, and canteen expenses has been apportioned on the basis of the employees ratio. So we cut the total overheads a portion over the different cost centers. Now the accounts department, the service department charges will be distributed over the other production departments. So we assume that the accounts department provides services to all departments. So therefore, let us first apportion or reapportion this 42,000 over P1, P2 and R&D. And how did we do that? On the basis of the employees of P1, P2 and R&D. So 200, 500 and 100. So accordingly, the overheads 42,000, which is accounts department, charged to P1, P2 and R&D department. And as we mentioned, that R&D department is providing service to P1 only. So therefore, we apportion the R&D department to P1. So the entire 26,250 will be charged to P1 and nothing to P2, because P2 does not consume any service from R&D department. Now if you total the overheads now, we can see that overheads have been 210,000 has been charged